One of the important new features in R70 is the ability to easily troubleshoot problems you may have with the IPS inspection. Let us take an example. A user has called you and said that a specific application that was developed in-house is being blocked, and it appears the blocking is being done by the gateway. You have opened the Smart View Tracker, filtered the query by source, and located a specific logline. Here in this demo mode, as filtering is not supported, we'll simply mark the log. You can see the date, the time, the action, the source, which is the IP that was given by this user, and the destination of this log. You can see that the protection type is protocol anomaly. You can see the severity of this protection. You can see the confidence level of this protection. You can see the performance impact of this protection. And you can see whether or not it is being flagged for follow-up. Other information includes the attack and attack information for this specific log and the protection's name. Let us double-click this log. This is the new log record details view. Here you can see the action taken, prevent. You can see the protection's name and the attack name. You can see the product, IPS, date, time, log number, type, origin, and all the information you're used to seeing in the past. Here on the right, you can see IPS related information. First thing you notice up top is the severity. Each protection has its own severity. It can be low, medium, high, or critical. Protections with critical severity are those that are usually denial of service or the ability to overtake the attacked host. Normally, you should focus on those protections with severity high or critical. Confidence level is how confident is the IPS engine that it actually found an attack. It is set to medium. The reason for this is because many homegrown applications may misuse port 53. It does not mean that this is an attack. This is simply an anomaly in the traffic. This is why the confidence level is not higher than medium. Here we can see the action, the protection name, attack, attack information, CVE, severity, confidence level, performance impact, protection type, and whether or not it's being followed. We can also open the protection in the Smart Dashboard and even add an exception fairly easily. Let's take this case for example. We would like to add an exception for this specific destination server, as this is a homegrown application that is using port 53 and is running as a server on this destination server, 10.0.215.233. Let's click Add Exception. This is the Add Edit Exception Role dialog. As you can see, all the information in this dialog has been automatically filled out for me. You can see the profile is set to any. It has selected the protection for me, non-compliant DNS. It has filled out the source IP, the destination IP, but it will not fill out the service, as the assumption is that the exception is for the protection but not on a specific service. It's also possible to choose a specific service. In the case here, we would like the source to be any network object and the destination to be this specific server. It's also possible to define the specific server as a network object and use that one. Exceptions can only be used with R70 gateways or above. You can either apply this exception to all R70 gateways and above, or to a very specific gateway. You can add a comment You click OK. Notice how this exception is added to the list of exceptions. In order to see all the exceptions in our current setup, simply click Network Exceptions here on the left. Once we install the policy, this exception will be in effect. It is also possible to go through a different process. Let's go back to the tracker. Instead of adding an exception, let's open the protection. As you can see, the Protection Details dialog opened. You can see that under the recommended profile, this protection is set to Prevent. You can double-click this. As you can see, we can modify the settings. We can set the protection to Detect or Inactive if we believe that it shouldn't be dropping any traffic. We can modify the track settings, or we can turn the Capture Packets feature. The Packet Capture feature, once enabled on a specific protection, will result in packet captures being collected with each future log that is emitted for this specific protection. The packet capture is saved on the gateway and may be accessed through the management. We click OK. OK here. And install a policy. In order to access the packet capture, here in the packet capture field, we will see two new links, View Packets Captured and Save Packet Capture. This allows you to essentially get the packet capture from the gateway and save it as a file on your hard drive or open it with a relevant application such as Wireshark. These functionalities are also accessible by right-clicking on the log line. You can see View Packets Capture, Save as Packet Capture, Open Protection, and Add Exception. Another thing I would like you to notice are the new predefined queries available with R70. Here you can see query for the most important logs generated by the IPS blade. These are logs for protections of severity high and critical, and confidence level medium, high, and high. The next query is a critical not prevented. These are logs for protections of severity critical and action detect instead of prevent. These are usually protections which have been downloaded recently and have not been set to prevent. This query lists all of the IPS logs. This one lists logs specifically for protocol anomaly protections. This lists protections that are flagged for follow-up. And this query lists logs for protections of type application control. This is where you would want to go if you want to see how the policy of application usage is being enforced in your environment. This is all for monitoring the logs in R70.